they urinate themselves in fear because they know that even if, no matter what they could do at this point in time, they're done, their life's over.
And see, that's a key part of it, too. As Alex said yesterday, it's about engendering the fear. And it's starting very mildly in America now. I can go back and look at a lot of the stuff that they did. Of course, they killed people. You know, as you mentioned, they mentioned just one person in this whole report that died from hypothermia because he was left exposed on in a cold area on concrete floor. I'm sure there's many more than that that died. And I'm not underestimating any of this waterboarding or any of the other stuff as being truly horrific. But some of the stuff that they did was just designed to humiliate people, making them wear women's underwear and that sort of thing. And when I look at that, I look at it and say, this is how it's beginning in the U.S. Much of what we see going on now with the TSA is merely humiliation. It's merely taking away your dignity. Mm-hmm. Once they take away your dignity, they take away your freedom. Once they take away your freedom, they can torture you. They can do anything they want to you. And, of course, we just had William Binney on again talking to Alex, and he said over and over again that what we have here is not an authoritarian regime but a totalitarian regime. And the way that they get there is by grabbing our information. And today we see another massive grab, if you will, of Congress trying to pass a law that presumes to give them the authority to take people's communications.
Well, it seems like basic training for civilians now. Mm-hmm. That's what the TSA is doing. Because when you're a soldier, what they do, they break you down, they humiliate you, treat you like crap, tell you you're nothing, till you get to a point where you're just empty, bottomless, and all they can do is build you back up the way they want you.
Yes, exactly.
And it seems like that's what's starting to happen now with the American public. That's what they're trying.
Very good analogy. It's all a psyop. It's all a psyop. Pulling it down, destroying everything, taking you down to nothing, and then telling and then reconstructing society. Yeah, absolutely. You know, one of the things that I saw, one of the reactions I saw that really stuck out to me was Chris Matthews talking to somebody who was complaining about the torturing. Says, come on, you're crazy if you think Al-Qaeda is going to stop torturing if we do. And I guess the question is, how do you tell then the difference between Al-Qaeda in the United States, if we both torture? How do you tell the difference between the United States and the Nazis when we bring them in with Operation Paperclip as consultants to teach us how to do what they did? How do you tell the difference between us? And of course, we created, the CIA created Al-Qaeda.
It's a child's reaction. You put a kid in a toy box and he hits one kid, and then that kid retaliates and hits back and he goes, well, mommy, he hit me first. Mm-hmm. It's the same thing. They're going, well, the Taliban does it. Mm-hmm. So you know, we might as well do the same thing.
Yeah, it's always, I forget who said this, but somebody said, when you fight monsters, you have to be careful that you don't become a monster yourself. Mm-hmm. And I see that happening. It's happened in America. Now we see all these things being done under color of law. I think it's interesting to go back and look at, let's take a look at the FBI director, James Comey. And of course, he seemed to be somewhat reluctant, but he went ahead and played ball. He was a deputy attorney general at the time. The New York Times reported that he argued repeatedly that the U.S. would regret using harsh methods, but he went along with the 2005 legal opinion asserting that the techniques used by the CIA were lawful, and he gave the green light for the CIA to use all 13 methods of interrogating terrorism suspects, including waterboarding and up to 180 hours of sleep deprivation. So there you go. He says it was ready to go out, and I concur. And those were emails that the New York Times got about that. Now, what happened to him? Did he get fired? Did he get disciplined? Did he go to jail? No, he got promoted to the head of the FBI.
That's what happens in America, apparently.
Yeah, that's what they want. That's what they want. We look at another guy, the guy who's head of Homeland Security, Jay Johnson. He was general counsel for the DOD. He defended NDAA indefinite detention because that's the other part of this. Okay, that's where it's going to be applied to Americans because, of course, they're claiming that the entire world, including domestic soil here, is at a state of war. So they're going to involve the military, and we're going to have the same kind of rules of engagement that we saw happened in in Iraq and Afghanistan with the CIA. They're going to essentially do the same thing. And this came out of the report talking about how in February 2012, the administration, represented by Jay Johnson, general counsel of the U.S. Department of Defense, defined the term associated forces so that they could apply it to essentially anybody with the NDAA. This is the guy who then subsequently becomes the head of Homeland Security and evidently is going to be passing for Obama, when he didn't even sign his executive order, he's going to leave it to Jay Johnson to
implement. I mean, you can already see the transformation, though, going from combat overseas to what's going on now with our militarized police as well, though.
Yes.
The shoot first, ask questions, maybe down the road at some point in time.
Yes.
But 9 times out of 10, like you said, these cops do bad stuff. They don't get indicted. Sweep it under the rug and move on.
And they're desperate. They're desperate to arm the police. It's not only the training, not only how they're teaching them that they're operating in a war zone, that the public is the enemy. As I pointed out before, they said the whole idea that they hadn't killed anybody who was innocent, and there wasn't any collateral damage, as the Pentagon pointed out.
And being choked to death on the ground by a police officer is torture to me.
Exactly. And when you look at this, the attitude that they had in country, saying that if anybody was a military-age male, there was a presumption that they were not innocent. And that's the way they're policing the inner city.
I've heard that many times when we're overseas. They're like, hey, that's an old enough guy. He could be a militant. Watch him.
Yeah.
Take him out if he makes a move.
Yeah. Which reminds us that, of course, people who are military-age males are the militia, and that's what's going to essentially be the only effect that we have to stand against this tyranny. We'll be right back with Joe Biggs.
This hour of GCN programming is proudly sponsored by BlockItPocket.com. Protect your privacy and data and render your phone or device completely undetectable. Go under the radar when your phone's not in use with BlockItPocket.com.
Hi, Ted Anderson with Midas Resources. Is it time to convert paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver yet? Get our 10 Reasons book free. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
In today's unstable environment, self-protection is critical. Civil unrest, riots, looting, it's happening now, right here in the United States, and your rights are at risk. If passed, H.R. 5344 would ban Level 3 and above body armor. Katie Armor is standing up for you. We offer the most affordable Level 3 body armor on the market. Katie Level 3 armor withstands pistol and rifle hits up to 7.62 NATO. Get yours at katiearmor.com. That's C-A-T-I-armor.com. Katie Armor, come and take it.
What looks good under your Christmas tree and tastes even better? Big Berkey water filters. Yes, the gift of clean water. A gift that provides a great foundation for achieving good health in the lives of your loved ones. A Big Berkey water filter gives them protection from bacteria, heavy metals, chlorine, fluoride, pesticides and herbicides, VOCs and more. And best of all, a Big Berkey water filter is a gift that lasts for many years with no additional investment. And that saves time and money in filter replacements that other water filters require and are even powerful enough to purify treated, untreated, or even stagnant pond water. As always, all orders over $50 are shipped free, and GCN listeners get 5% off all ceramic filter systems. Order online at BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com, spelled Big, B-E-R-K-E-Y, WaterFilters.com, or call 877-99-BERKEY. That's 877-99-BERKEY. Gift well this Christmas. Give a Big Berkey water filter.
Did you know by age 50, half of all men have an enlarged prostate? This means more urges to urinate, longer bathroom trips, waking at night to urinate, or issues with sex. If this sounds familiar, call us now, because we're shipping free bottles of Super Beta Prostate to listeners of this station. Super Beta Prostate is a non-prescription formula guaranteed to reduce the symptoms of your enlarged prostate. It's yours free. Pay only shipping and handling. Just call 1-800-852-1820. In clinical trials, the ingredient in Super Beta Prostate was shown to reduce urges to urinate, improve bladder emptying, reduce waking at night to urinate, and improve quality of life. This Super Beta Prostate free offer is for listeners of this station, but it won't last. Don't wait. Just call 1-800-852-1820. That's 1-800-852-1820. Call 1-800-852-1820.
Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight here with Staff Sergeant retired Joe Biggs, and we're talking about what he saw on the ground in terms of torture. We've been looking at the people who are at the top of this, providing legal cover, who have not been shamed, they've not been punished, they've not been demoted or fired. No, they've been promoted to the positions of head of the CIA, head of the FBI, head of Homeland Security. That's what happens when you cover for these people. They basically move you up. One of the things I was looking at in the torture report, they were talking about the memorandum of notification. It seems to me it was more restrictive than even what they've put in with the NDAA. They had a quote in there where it says, "We are not permitted," they said, "to detain someone merely upon a suspicion that he or she has valuable information about terrorists or planned acts of terrorism." And yet they've been given a much broader range in the NDAA. They say merely they have to suspect that there's substantial support. And as you're pointing out, they were just going out and rounding people up, torturing them, and releasing them. They're essentially poking both sides of the war, just as we've seen them do in Vietnam, as we've seen them do in every kind of conflict. We've got the CIA operating here secretly as an unaccountable, compartmentalized government that is over and above the people who presumably have some oversight over them or appoint the head of the CIA. I mean, there is no oversight, and we're not going to see even the kind of oversight that we saw out of this report once Richard Burr gets in, because he's publicly gone on record saying that he doesn't think there's ever anything that the CIA does that ought to be made public.
Yeah, that's out of control.
Yeah.
You know, like you said, the head of the FBI, the head of the CIA, they should call that group, they should call these guys Monsters, Inc.
Yeah.
Because that's all they are. It's just an incorporation of monsters. Just, it's mind-blowing to know the fact that they can go on national TV and swear an oath that things like this aren't happening.
Yes.
And to say that and to look in the eyes of the American people and just blatantly lie. I just don't understand it, especially when I've been out there and I've seen it happen. I've seen it happen since Obama's been president numerous times.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Nothing changed after Obama got in. And we're going to talk later in the program. Yes, absolutely. We're going to talk later in the program about how the GOP has betrayed their voters who wanted them to get control of the illegal amnesty program, to shut down Obamacare, to do so many things and basically let people look and see what's in spending bills. We've had now two separate weeks where they basically introduced something on a Tuesday night, late, 1,600-page bill, and said we've got to pass it by Thursday, giving congressmen and the press and the public only a few hours to look at what's in it. We're going to look at some of the things that have already shown up in the bill. Of course, there's not enough time for everybody to know everything that's in it, but there's some horrendous stuff in that. And Obama did the same thing to his supporters. A lot of people voted for him because they wanted to end the torture that was going on. They wanted to end the wars, and yet he's given us more wars. He's continued the torture. He added the drone program and put one of the guys who was giving legal cover for the torture program in charge of the drone program, who is now the head of the CIA, John Brennan. It just keeps going.
And now they're going to send more troops to Iraq. Yes.
Yeah.
You know, we're going to shut that down, he says. We're going to close down Guantanamo. We're going to do all this. I haven't seen any of that happen yet, and it's only getting worse, and it's going to continue to get worse here in America, because like I said, we're making a transformation from combat life overseas, and that's starting to pop up here in the homeland as well.
That's what people need to understand. They need to understand that this was merely training and preparation. They need to see how all of the groundwork is being laid for a massive tyranny here, how the NDAA and the legislation that was passed today, that's all going to be used against the American public. You and I saw it there at the training facility. When we come back, right after the break, we're going to talk about some more stuff that you saw in Afghanistan and Iraq, because that's what's missing. There's not any interview of the people who were there, who saw that, nothing of the people who were victims of that. Nobody who did it is being called in for questioning. Only the whistleblower who exposed it goes to prison. We'll be right back.
Thank you for listening to GCN. Visit GCNlive.com today.
From the water table to our soils to the atmosphere itself, our world is becoming more and more toxic each and every day. But it's not just the air outside that's toxic. Indoor air has been shown to have 2 to 5 times higher concentrations of pollutants than even outdoor air. And most Americans spend 90% of their time inside using toxic chemicals within their homes. There are more than 42 million smokers in the United States. Well over 1,000 types of mold and mildew linked to numerous conditions. And don't forget the fact that 6 million Americans live with pets. pets they're allergic to as well. When I began to research these statistics, it was clear to me it was time to start cleansing my lungs in order to combat the toxic environment that we cannot escape, but that we can fight back against. Made with organic and wild cultivated herbs and manufactured in the USA, the new InfoWars Life Lung Cleanse is here in a convenient spray bottle that can be brought with you throughout any toxic environment. Now available exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.